Namaste, gods, goddesses, and emissaries of light. This is Dr. Shreya Tayen. If you are new to my channel, please like, subscribe, and do not forget to hit the notification bell so you can be updated on my latest and my current videos. All right. As you can see from the title, I will be talking about manifestation. This is titled Manifestation 360, If You Only Knew Your Power. I have 10 manifestation tips that I'm going to go over with you right now. And I will also do a mini reading for all signs on this reading as well. So I figured what perfect opportunity that it is so I can discuss these things with you and help you guys to be more powerful manifestors as well. So the first thing that I wanted to do is, I got so many, and you guys, I didn't want this to be a long drawn out video because I do have more readings that I have to do for my clients. And I also have some workings that people hired me to do for tonight, for the full moon. So I'm going to keep this brief, but I'm going to give you details. And I'm going to start with this. All right. So first and foremost, for those of you that do not feel fully empowered or in your power, I recommend this book, The Secret of Your Immortal Self by Guy Finley. This book is about realizing the divinity within you and not looking outside of yourself. You are conscious co-creators with source energy. You are the creator of your own universe. What happens, what shows up in your life, whether it be good, bad, right, wrong, or indifferent, is all of your making. And for some of you, you may not believe that. You may believe that there's an outside God that's controlling and pulling the strings behind the scenes. But that is never true. Source energy does not interfere with our lives when it comes to particular situations because we have free will. And part of free will is making choices that shape and mold our future. Now, I'm not going to say that there are not divine contracts because we all know in the twin flame union that within itself is a divine contract between us, another party, and source energy. But what I'm saying here is that those integral little, let's say, hiccups that tend to come on our table of existence in our lifetime is all our doing. We can't blame a God outside of us, or we can't blame the devil. We're both God and we're both Satan. We're both our higher and we're both our lower selves, which is represented by Satan and God, you see. I'm not saying that there is not a benevolent being. Obviously, you guys know that I definitely give a lot of acknowledgement and honor to Yad-Heh-Vah-Heh. Okay, first of all, there would not be any Turo without Yad-Heh-Vah-Heh. Yad meaning the very beginning. Okay, but I'll get into that maybe on another video. I don't want to get distracted. But this is one of the books that I recommend for you. And I like, I don't know about you guys, but I like to go in the chapters just to see what the content is about. And as you can see, it helps you to look inside the invisible mirror of the immortal self, let go and awaken to the whole new you, realize the crowning moment of life, find a secret entrance into life immortal, the winds of faith. It's impossible to hide and see this at the same time. Start giving yourself what you really want. Okay. It's a lot of stuff in here, you guys. And I'm just going to only go through this 1 second page and just, you know, be done because there's so much. But the secret of being successful in all worlds, perfection can't be possessed. Excuse me. The pain of my father. Remember your internal right to be free. Walk through any fearful moment. You are created to change. The power to change your past. Stop complaining and start changing. I got to do this all over again. Stop complaining and start changing. There we go. 10 ways to stop feeling sorry for yourself. Discover your unseen attachment to heart. Use unwanted moments to set you free. Be lifted in the world of the vine. Shatter the bonds of false beliefs and be free. The 3 stages of self-realization. And it also, you guys, have where you can just pretty much grow into like loving, lasting relationships, how to really relax and release yourself into your being, seeing the light. This is a very good book. I think I'm done touching bases on what is all entailed in here because I covered some pretty good ground here. Next, you have one of my favorite books, which is The Sorcerer's Companion. The Sorcerer's Companion is a guide to the magical world of Harry Potter. I don't know if you guys seen the Harry Potter movie. Most of us have. But for anyone that is a high priestess or a magician, you are lacking if you don't have this book. Okay, I won't go into the details like I did the other one, but I mean, it pretty much covers everything that you can possibly think of. Tarot, sorcery, boundaries. Oh my God, just please get this book. You're not manifesting to the fullest if you don't have this book in your possession. Okay. So those are tools number one for all manifestors. You need to get that book. And that book, I do apologize. I didn't mention because I usually mention the author. It's actually more than one. Okay. It's Alan Zolo Kronzik and Elizabeth Kronzik, husband and wife. See, this is what we need to be doing with our twins. We need to be manifesting stuff like that together. That, I guarantee you, that couple are twin flames. Seriously. It takes a certain type of essence to be able to work together, and most of us know that. All right, so the second thing that you need to do in order for you to be able to be a good manifester is to journal. Okay. Here's my journal. It is named after my business, which is called Good Vibes. Okay. I have a business called Good Vibes Holistic Center because I am a doctor and I do run that. I have different color pens that you can manifest with, and I use all 3 pens for all different situations. You can use different colors for different manifestations, but these are the ones that I use on a regular and consistent basis when I am wanting to manifest something into existence. So if you're wanting to manifest love, you would manifest and write with a red pen. Also, you can manifest love with a pink pen, but this is more for passion. So if you want to have both passion and love, you do both, the pink and the red together. Next you have, and I won't get into how to do that because this video, like I said, I'm only allotted so much time because I have to get back to what I'm doing, but this is a black pen. Okay, black matter. Anything, business, personal, education, just don't do it with love, okay? If you want to do a love manifestation, a visualization for this new moon, use red. But money is very good to do it in black ink when you're wanting to manifest money and the others that I mentioned. So those are the 3 pens that I would recommend to use. There are other colors, like I said, you can Google, but these are the ones that I use primarily. When you're wanting to manifest, always journal and then always keep your goals written down. Okay, I learned that from the Think and Grow Rich book. Write it down. Helps it to manifest a whole lot faster. All right. There's something that's missing that was up here that I don't see. Thought I brought it in here. Well, I don't actually have a bottle of it, so I'll use this. You can use this water or Florida water. Rue water is really good too, but this is for cleansing and clearing your space, your altars. When I wipe my altars down with my deities, I use Florida water, and you can use rue water too. Rue water is mainly for manifesting more so, but it's cleansing, it's clearing. But I wanted to have, actually, you know what? I can have my daughter go get it. Yayla, go in my bathroom. You know where I keep that big old bucket, that gold bucket with a lot of essential oils? It's like a lot of essential oils in my closet. Look in there and go get me the Florida water. Because most people don't know what it looks like. But this is something that you can, like, if you do a 7-day candle and you want to draw something in, this is what I use. Okay, you can get this at the tienda, which is the Mexican store, and they will sell that there. And if not, Amazon. Thank you, love. Okay, this is Florida water. I like Florida water. I like using it because when I'm doing a spiritual bath before, and I'll get to my spray in a moment. But I'm just telling you, for those of you that need to have this real quick and to grab it for this energy that's coming in for this full moon, which is going to last for the next 3 days, that's when it's the strongest, okay? It can last up to a week with the energy, but I'm saying far as like manifestation purposes, okay? Use this energy. But do a spiritual bath. It's always good to do a spiritual bath when there is a full moon. You want to make sure that you clear your aura. I only put like 3 tablespoons into my water because this stuff is like, to me, I feel like really, really strong, and that's really all that you need. You can also use it before you do tarot. You can put some on your hand and splash it on your cards. You can also clean your house with this, like put it in your mop bucket. Mop your hot, every corner of your house that has where you can mop. In your bathrooms, you want to put it in your bathrooms, mop your bathroom with it. Oh my God, there's so many uses of this water that I use, but when you're wanting to manifest, just cleanse your hands with it first before you start writing things out so you're clear channel. And so yeah. Next, you want to use sage or Palo Santo. I have both. I love this by Sun's Eye. Sun's Eye, they make really good drawing sprays. For those of you that want to manifest love, you can use the love drawing Mystic Blend spray, which is something you can spray directly on your body. I spray this directly on my body where I used to. I haven't used them since I have my Kit Karma and the ass spray, and I'm gonna be 100% with you. I'm keeping it really real. Okay. As you can see, this is my Kit Karma and the ass spray, and as you can see, look, it's pretty much gone. It's a little bit in there. I go through maybe a bottle of this a week. Okay. Because I use it before all of my readings. I use it to cleanse my aura. I use it to take spiritual baths with. I use this thing for everything. Before I meditate, I spray with this. Gee, Louise. When after company leaves, I spray it. I spray it on my hands before I deal with tarot. I spray my altars with it to cleanse and clear. I spray my auric field to raise my vibration. This does more than anything I have ever used, and it's my own spray. Okay? And I make this spray on every full moon. That's another reason why I need to get off of here as well, is because I have some orders I need to fill, and I need to charge this, the ones that I've made, the batches that I made with the full moon, because they are charged with the full moon and they do carry the full moon energy and sacred geometry. And this is why it works. And if for some of you that don't know about geometry, the whole universe is made out of geometry, okay? Signs, numbers, and symbols. And so is my Kit Karma Asprey, which is my favorite. All right. Now, let's get into the fifth thing that you would need to do. You would need to get you a white candle. I have blue because right now we're talking about the throat chakra. This is what this moon is helping us to do, for us to speak our truth. So I have blue candles right now. You just want to stare into the candle, you know, stare at the flame as long as you can. And kind of like stare until you just kind of like drift. And this helps you to open up to receive downloads, because there are download codes that are coming in. And it will behoove you, if you do not take advantage of staring into a candle, the flame, actually. And get those downloads, baby. Next, tarot. Okay. You can use tarot for manifestation purposes. Today, or tonight rather, I'm using the Moonology Oracle, which is what is represented here. And that is the reading that I'm going to get into for your full moon reading. And then also, I use my own deck to manifest. I have a Kindle that's going on over there to help to bring me into union and the inner union. Well, I'm already in the inner union with male and female, but it helps to magnetize the vibration of my union and to make sure that we're in harmony with one another. So I use the divine masculine and the divine feminine from this deck. Let's see if I got any examples of that. Because that's my private deck. I do. Common. I do, but for whatever reason, this is my prototype deck. I thought it was in there. It was in there. Maybe my kids might have took it out because they play with my cards. Anyway, for those of you that have followed my channel, you know what they look like. But you can use the divine feminine and the divine masculine out of this deck to manifest union within. For those of you that have not already had 5D union, I already had 5D union last year with Michael the Archangel Raphael and Gabriel. Took me to Yod-Heh-Vah-Heh, which is the first time that I was introduced to Yod-Heh-Vah-Heh during my holy matrimony or my cosmic union. All right, so you also want to manifest with incense. Incense is very good. I use this one. This is my favorite. This will bring money in the front door and the back door, I promise you. Look, this is done. See this? Yeah, it's nothing in there. See? It's all gone. I need to order more. So I can actually pitch that, but I kept it so I can show you what it looks like. Okay? So, yeah. You guys can manifests a lot of money with those incense. Now, I also want to talk about crystals, right? These are on my altar, and I manifest with these every day. This is a jade elephant made from jade, okay? I'm always making sure that he's facing the east, but I also make sure that the other ones are facing the other directions because I want my money coming in north, south, east, and west, okay? Pyrite. Pyrite is a very good manifestation stone, matter of fact. This one is very unique and it's worth a lot of money because it also has quartz growing in the grooves. Now, I promise you, when I first got this, the owner did not know that there was quartz growing in the groove. And the more that I manifest money, this is no joke, the more that more of the quartz grow into this stone. Okay, every time I look at the stone, I see more quartz grow into it. And I'm not even joking. Like when I first got this pyrite, it was all pyrite, no quartz. Now you can see quartz is popping up through there. See the white? That's quartz crystal. And Mario, the singer, tried to take this from me. And I'm like, no, I like you, but I don't like you that much. You cannot get my pyrite. And this is cistrine. Cistrine is very good. Pyrite is good for money. Cistrine and pyrite together makes you happy with your money. There's a sense of drawing in money if you're not going to be happy with the money that's coming in, right? So with that being said, this makes you happy. People say money don't make you happy. With cistrine and pyrite, it does. And that is no joke. I am being so serious. Now, it's also with this new moon energy, it's about being giving, to give more. I can give you a challenge now. If you donate to my channel, and I'm not just saying this because I want you to donate to my channel, I want to put you to the test. If you donate to my channel, watch how the universe is going to bless you. The more that you give, the more that you receive. The more that you want to be loved, the more love that you give, the more you're going to receive in return. You see, the more that you want knowledge, you read books like this, and guess what happens? You come into knowledge, you come into more knowledge. So it's about giving more than receiving, and then you automatically receive because that's a law of attraction, okay? And that's how it happens for you. The last thing that I wanted to let you know about is the candles. When you do candles, also make sure that you are doing some type of meditation. That helps to magnetize a visualization. You can do subliminals. There's just really all kind of things you can do, but I have a new moon meditation for you that I will attach to this video. Okay. And that will help you with your manifestation and whatever it is that you're trying to manifest in this new moon. All right, so let's go ahead and get into the reading. I call in air, fire, water, earth, spirit, and ether. And I also call upon Yajnavalkya, who will be able to give me the information that is necessary for this reading and all directions, time and space, past, present, and future. I can't recall if I did that or not. If I did it twice, it doesn't matter. Least I did it. All right, so with this new moon, all signs, you're being called to hold your vision. Do not take your eyes off of the prize because what you are seeking is also seeking you. You are very powerful. And right now, there is a wave of energy that is coming in with this full moon that is encouraging you to look on the positive side of the moon. Look on a bright side of the moon, okay? The bright side of the moon is shining upon you. So it's shining upon you in a particular situation. I feel like the situation that you're connected to is allowing you to be tested. A lot of you are being tested, and you're being asked to see things from a different spectrum and to be productive and not let negativity to creep in to make you counterproductive, like with karmic situations. Not to dwell on those because remember, that was self-created by you through a soul contract before you came into existence. So it's asking you to hold whatever is dear to your heart and keep it there. to focus more on what you want instead of focusing on what it is that you do not want. Next, your emotions are running wild. So it says, emotions are running high. You are so sensitive to this energy that's coming in right now that you can't even see straight. It is affecting every fiber of your being. Everything that you think about, the way that you go about organizing your day-to-day duties, still have the vibration of these emotions that are kind of like scattered. I feel like the new moon or the full moon is going to bring some new awareness into your psyche. It's going to move you from a place of not knowing into a place of I know. Because we have been healing for so long, you guys. How much more healing do you need? It is time for you to stake your claims on what it is that is your birthright and what source energy told you that belongs to you, whether it's a twin flame, whether it's a job, career, finances, whether it's a house, whether it's a vehicle, whatever it is that source has told you, because I feel like many of you have gotten confirmation of what's coming in for you. Whatever it is, remove the emotions to the side and think more logical about the situation, because over emotions can consume us when we overly think about something that God has already gave us confirmation that's going to happen. So you're being asked to not let your emotions run so high, but to ground yourself, get you some grounding stones, get you my Kit Karma ass spray. I'm not playing. I'm telling you, whenever I'm off kilter, I spray that. And it instantaneously works. But you're at a place right now where you're coming into your own. You know what you need to do. You just need to step forward, put your best foot forward, and do exactly what it is that is necessary. And I believe everything will work out. Next, you have, it's time to release negativity. Okay. One of the things that I love about the full moon is that that's exactly what you use the energy for. When you release what no longer serves you and what's negative and what's holding you back, toxic relationships, narcissistic people, it could be friends, family, or lovers. When you release all of that, it helps for you to open up to the new. It allows for the new to come in and usher in and pour upon you what your heart desires, what your heart beats for, what your heart lives for. Those are the manifestation energies that you need to be focused on right now in this energy, because the time has come now, you see, for you to release all that no longer serves you. Who cares about would've, should've, could've? Nobody. Because you can't do anything with that energy. But if you give yourself the opportunity to come into existence with being fully present in this now moment, you will be surprised on what is going to come into manifestation for you. It is going to be beyond your wildest dreams. Trust me. It is going to be so unfathomable that your friends and family alike, when they see you come into existence with the very thing that God is calling you to claim, there are going to be a lot of people that are going to be jealous because they're going to wish that they had the same thing that you had, but they didn't do the things that you did to get it. And so therefore, what is yours. And so source energy is telling you at this now moment, quit being overcritical, both about yourself and about the chain of events that have taken place. But open up your heart to receive something else that's better, that's bigger, that's more promising, that's more trustworthy. Because you can't trust something that you know that's not good for you, right? So this is why, this is the very reason why you're being asked to let go. And how fitting that this card came out. This is the card of all cards, because guess what? This is the full moon in Sagittarius, which is where we are with the strawberry moon. Yes, we are there. And as you can see, we have to look at the bigger picture. What is it, as yourself, what is it that you're not seeing about this particular situation? Yeah, it may have been a situation that have hurt you, or it could be a situation that didn't hurt you. It could be a situation that was something that blindsided you. But what can you learn? What are the lessons? What are the lessons inside of this blessing? You see, what is it that you need to know about this particular issue or situation that will help to ground you and to stabilize you and the energy and the fortitude of faith? This full moon, more than anything, requires you having faith in the universe and knowing that the universe is about to show up and show out for you. It is about to do so many things for you that are unfathomable, that are unthinkable, that are indescribable. You see, this full moon energy is a blessing. You've been asking for your next wind, and the universe just blew it in for you. All right, I have come to the conclusion of this beautiful reading. I hope you enjoyed my manifestation tools. I hope that they can benefit you as well. I know that they will. All you have to do is put them into practice. Make sure that you're clear and clean. I cannot stress this enough, and I will emphasize this before I leave. Please make sure that you cleanse your aura before you manifest. You don't need anything that is attached to you, dragging on, holding on to you to pull you back or to block what it is that you're trying to manifest. And I hear so many people give manifestation tips, and I always wonder why they never give the most important one. And that is, you have to be a clear, open channel to receive whatever it is that you're looking for. You have to be in exact vibrational alignment in order for you to pull in whatever it is that you're trying to pull in. You can't be in a vibrational alignment if your aura is dirty. It has to be cleansed and cleared. And I am so grateful that before I ended this video, I heard my angel say, let them know they have to cleanse their auras. And so I did. So I'm going to go ahead and leave you with that. It is a good karma to like, share, comment, subscribe, or leave a love donation if you feel inclined to. Or you can purchase a gift from my Amazon wish list and it will appear on a channel. I now wrap you in my love and I cloak you with the light of Christ consciousness. I will do an extended reading for all signs. If you want to go with me on the other side, I will discount it only for today for $11. And I will see you there. Namaste.